let's play against the Rockets. You have two message waiting. Go to team status. All right, let's see. David Lee is upset with the fact that we have yet to extend his contract. Andrew Bogut wants to talk to you about improving his organizational role. Okay. How do I talk to them? My GM. Let's see here. David Lee wants an extension. Sure, why not? We'll give him one. Sure, we'll go ahead. There. Yeah, that's good enough. Alright, how about that? Give him a shot. Seems like a fair. There we go. There we go. We'll worry about Bogut later. Alright, here we go. Andrew Bogut has been growing increasingly frustrated with his role within the team. Do you plan on making him a starter or do you letting him stew? Who is it Noah? I can't remember who the heck's my, what, center or power forward? Fine. Alright, who the freak's my... Oh, I didn't even get the check. Darn it. Oh, he's going to be kind of pissed off. I said, wait, there we go. I can go change. Okay, good. I was about to say, he's going to be freaking jacked if I said he can become a starter, and then all of a sudden, I don't do it. I don't roll along with it. All right, let's go check this out. So, roster. So, Noah's my... I don't really know if I want to start him over Noah, though. Oh, yeah, I don't... Maybe my power forward... Well... Bogut? Come on, man! You know, I don't really want to start yet over Noah! What the freak, man? Oh, yay! Noah's better than you! Well, I totally lied to the media. Like, I'm not starting Bogut. Sorry about your damn luck, Bogut, but you're not going to be starting for my team. Not starting over Noah, son. Get over it. Just get over it, son.
The 2K Sports Pregame
Show. All right, here we go. Let's watch Pregame Show.
Hello, everybody. Ernie Johnson here alongside Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. Welcome to the NBA on 2K Sports. Pepsi Center, the site, Denver Nuggets, the home team, and today they'll be playing against the Houston Rockets. And for Houston, they've been playing terrific basketball to start the season. They're showing all the signs they'll be able to keep that momentum going, too, looking more and more confident each time out. And Jimmy Butler, the 30th pick out of Marquette back in 2011, every season he's improved, and Shaq made a huge jump last year, didn't he?
Last year, he won the Most Improved Player Award. You know, he showed me he can get it done in the mid-range, around the rim, on the defensive end. He stepped up.
Yeah, that was a career year for him, all across the board. You know, he averaged 19 points, you know, 3 assists. And he's still got plenty of room to develop, Ernie, because, you know, he just touched the surface of how good he can actually be.
That's what I was going to say. You put those numbers up in that year and get everybody's attention, and you're an all-star. What do you expect this time around?
Well, now the defense know you. So you have to change some things and add some things as well. So it's going to be an interesting year for Jimmy Butler. I think they'll that this kid is ready for stardom.
Just about ready to tip this thing off. Let's get it down to Kevin Harlan.
All right. Jimmy Butler, watch him. We better watch him, team. We got destroyed by Blake Griffin last time. Let's not get destroyed by Jimmy Butler this time. Let's go. We're at the frickin' Pepsi Center. We can't lose again. Alright, let's go.
Everyone is in their seats here at the Pepsi Center as the Nuggets look to grab a win.
Come on,
here
Noah.
Town Denver, Colorado. The Houston Rockets coming to this one after a win against the Nets. And there wasn't much
there
question
go.
As
nice.
To how that game was going to turn out. They absolutely put the hammer down on them.
Yeah, ran away with that game, mainly in part because of their offense.
Yeah, the ball movement and player movement, so crisp and sharp, and it led to a lot of high-quality shots.
We've got a chance here to set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for this one. So on the floor for Houston.
Ah, dang it, I couldn't get anyone open.
Then there's Tyler Hansbrough.
Come on, stop him. Stop him. Oh, come on. Charging. Not freaking foul Kyle Korver. Bull crap. Dang it.
Live up to his new contract, Clark. Last year, a four-year max deal signed heading into the season.
Yeah, and the way max contracts work nowadays, even the upper mid-tier guys are getting it. A trend that will probably continue, at least in the near future. I don't like it, though. There are only a small number of guys that are really max contract players in the NBA.
Here is Lawson, following the basket by Chris Paul. Hayward outside. Splitter sets a screen for Hayward. Three-pointer, Butler.
Come on, rebound. Oh, man. Dang it. Jimmy
when
Butler.
He's got that much of a height advantage on the perimeter. It's really tough on the defender. Easy three-pointer.
Paul dishes to Lee. Back to Paul.
Come on. Someone get open,
just
man.
Just five to shoot. It's blocked.
Oh, come on.
And here in the first, closing in on 2 minutes play.
Wilson
has the open look. Offline with his three.
Surprise there.
One of three from the field to start this one so far. The drive by Lee. That's
yes,
good.
There we go.
Lee's got his first 2 points of the night.
And bullseye with that assist. Nice delivery there in traffic.
Kicks to Hansbrough.
Come on, get that.
And out of bounds.
Oh, it's our ball. Nice. Do it.
Nuggets have gone 2 for 4 from the field so far today. Ball against Lawson. Paul kicks it to Noah.
Pick.
Screen by Lee.
Pick.
Noah drives in. The pass to Lee.
Ah.
Paul,
dang it.
Right side. Just 5 on the clock. The Nuggets need to get a shot off here.
Ah, oh, come on.
And he rushed that one, no doubt about it. The D. Alice position, you could see the frustration on his face.
Yeah, the Rockets were able to make it to the second spot in the West at the very end of the season. Actually came down to the last day.
No.
They could have ended as low as 6th going into the final games.
Come on, Rebound.
You can
yes.
see the defenders afraid to
go,
kind
go,
of
go, go.
His way a lot of times when he's on his way to the basket. But on that one, they
yes.
Win. Lee gets the bucket.
He always knows where his teammate's going to be. And, Kevin, that will let him put the ball where he wants it, right waiting for him.
Last season for the Rockets, they finished as the number 2 team in the West to the Golden State Warriors. But you know,
they had to oh, come on, he makes
in
it.
Part because of injuries.
Dang it.
The Rockets did well to come in second in the West, but it was because they took care of the so-called easy games. 33 wins in the conference, but a record of 12-16.
No!
The other playoff teams.
Oh, come on.
Oh, and a fast break for the Rockets. Lawson with the ball. First quarter of action, just under 3.5 minutes played. Hayward outside. There's the three. That one
falls.
Coming off Lawson's feet. And it's 7 points for Gordon Hayward. Al Paul. A 32-point game for him in the win against Milwaukee.
There we go.
The 4 big steals on the night, getting after it on both ends. Only took them a few seconds to answer the 3 ball with one of their own.
Greg, we've got a three-point battle taking shape here.
And here is Butler following the three from Chris Paul. Korver against Butler. Back to Lawson. And he can't answer back. The three-pointer offline.
Go, go, go.
Ariza gets
the what was that? That was a terrible freaking pass, dude. Come on.
Lawson's against Paul. Hayward outside. Hansbro with the ball. He's against Lee. Here's Butler. And he takes it under the glass. Butler's got 5 points so far.
And that's another assist for a team that is putting on a clinic on how to share the ball.
And I love the mentality that they've had. If a shot isn't there, they're not forcing it. They're moving it side to side until they finally get the one they want.
Denver with a platoon swap here on the floor. Houston with a big group substitution here. Harry Sanders is checked in for Splitter. Villanueva comes in for Hansbro. Oubre is checked in for Gordon Hayward. And it's Exum in for Ty Lawson. Now here is Bogut. Puts it up. And
Gordon
takes a nice bounce off the right iron and down. Bogut's got his first basket of the night. Houston's gone 3 of 5 from three-point land so far in the ballgame. Exum passes to Oubre. He dishes it to Villanueva. Screened by Sanders. Villanueva up top, defended by Young. Exum with a wide open look. A three-pointer off the mark. Nuggets trail. Watson with it. Now defended by Exum. We've got 28 seconds left in the first. Bogut down low. Villanueva covering.
Nice.
Bogut gets the bucket.
This has been a thriller. You cannot say enough about the way these two teams have competed.
All indications, Greg, are that this game is going down to the wire. I mean, I'd be surprised, actually shocked, if it ended any other way.
They get it again. A second chance effort. And
oh, man, he gets his own rebound.
Butler's got 7 points. Clark, a lot of give and take between these sides early.
Kevin, how about 6 lead changes in this half already?
Yeah, and both teams look like they came to play. We should have a
traveling. Dang it.
And certainly an intriguing matchup tonight. Let's hear from Trevor Ariza on his
You're playing against a team that is very scrappy. You know, they want to win as well. You got to come ready to play. You got to be ready for everything, and you got to be ready to claw to get this win tonight.
Ariza might as well be describing his own game, Clark. Scrappy, ready to play, ready for anything, ready to claw to get that win.
Well, you know, he does have that kind of all-around, all-out game going back to his days at UCLA. I mean, when you combine that with his talent, he's a guy who, no matter where he's been, his teammates rave about him and respect him.
Oh, great. Hayward, Gordon Hayward. My God, dude.
The game we've seen so far from the Rockets, guys.
It's just been a long-range battle for them, and one that they're winning right now.
Yeah, sharp shooting from deep, a big part of why they're up.
They've got Kyle Korver. Bogut out there with Young. Then it's Watson, and it's Bellinelli in at the three slot. That's the group. And it was great to watch C.J. Miles last season. Finally, Clark got some significant playing time.
Yeah, and took advantage of it. With the Pacers having Paul George on the sidelines due to injury until late in the season, they got a
dang
nice
it
in contribution from C.J. Miles.
Exum by 4. Exum kicks to Lawson. That 3 off the mark. Korver dishes to Watson. And the rejection by Sanders.
Oh, my God!
Korver against Lawson. Here's Hayward. It's hauled in by the Nuggets. They put up a nice win against the Bucks the last time out.
They just weren't challenged. I mean, nearly as much as they should have been in that game, at least when they had the ball.
Yeah, it was a mismatch. I mean, the defense from the start was on its heels practically the entire game.
The Nuggets shooting their initial free throws of the game right here. And we've seen it all, guys. The Nuggets have been in free fall the last couple of years. Part of that is their play at home, where GA, they used to be invincible.
You remember back in the day, Kevin? Oh, I mean, one of the most difficult places to play was in Denver. I mean, you're dealing with the thin air.
Come on.
Carl just prided his team on what they did at home. And it's Paul penetrating. Ariza has the open look.
Are you serious?
Lee passes to Paul. Down it goes.
There.
Good basket. He's now 3-for-4.
Pretty, pretty passive. Timely recognition as to where the open man was. You know, Denver ended with a 19-22 record at home last season, and that's a far cry from when the Nuggets would typically win 30 or more games at home.
But they get it back. The Nuggets trail by 3. To the middle. Here's Ariza. Power down.
There we go.
Let him into the lane.
That is some real serious dime dropping there. Exquisite assist.
Houston's gone 1-3 from way outside since the start of the second quarter.
And you'd have to go all the way back to their dreadful 2003 campaign to find the last time the Nuggets went below 500 at home. Very strange to see them be just mediocre in this building last season.
Go.
No breathing room at all to take that shot.
Paul kicks it to Noah. At the elbow, Lee. Good.
And yes.
Assist from Noah. And that's now 6 points for David Lee. Guys, what a tight start to the game this has been.
You know what? Can you believe there have been 7 lead changes already, guys?
Wow.
And it's still in the first half. This could be a wild one.
Hayward on the wing. Ariza covering. And
Hayward.
I love his shot selection today. He set the bar for the rest of the
freaking
team.
Gordon Hayward's,
you know,
killing me.
I wonder if Gordon Hayward can lead a team to the promised land. However, as just a sophomore, he led a non-powerhouse
play physical defense. That's not what my defense is doing.
Just one basket away from winning it all.
Nick Calathes is checked in for the Nuggets. And a switch here also for Houston. Butler's checked in.
Wow. I missed.
They get a hand.
Oh, come on!
Lawson against Paul. There's a screen by Hansbrough. On its way from Hayward for 2. Gets the front of the rim and out. Going back to Hayward, he took that buzzer beating half court shot, Clark, that would have won his school the championship. You actually called that game.
What?
The backboard and rim,
the frick happened? Did that count?
Well, Hayward's the
think
kind
it
of guy
did.
He's willing to put his team on his back and try to carry him. He's willing to take that responsibility on, whether he can deliver at the highest level.
Come on.
Oubre's checked in.
Obviously, they're evenly matched teams on the inside. The rebound numbers are very even.
Yeah, impressive effort from both on the backboard.
Noah, the screen. Lee, that's good.
Yes.
Well, guys, this first half has been about as tightly contested as you could hope for.
Well, neck and neck, how about that? I mean, ferociously
competitive.
I mean,
no!
Tight as me in an airplane bathroom.
Oh, he missed, yes.
That's not the visual I was looking for right now, but there have been a lot of lead changes. My goodness.
Lee, a screen on Lawson. Paul dishes to Lee. Rockets with the
lead. I think he was surprised by how much space he had there and just rushed the shot a little bit.
Butler goes in. Lawson fires. And Chris
no! What is going on with this freaking fouls? Come on!
Fighting over those screens.
And Greg, come on, get that.
Especially when the ball is in his hands. I mean, come on now. You know he doesn't miss too many open looks like that.
Catching up on the changes for Denver. Andrew Bogut, he's checked in for Noah. Young comes in for Lee. Bellinelli, he's checked in for Nick Calathes. And it's Watson in for Chris Paul. Thaddeus Young provides a lot of things.
Ends
of the floor, you can plug him into almost any lineup and make it work.
Yeah, he's an ideal basketball player because of his versatility. I think that's one of his greatest strengths. Not only can he play the 3 or 4, he can go inside and outside, too.
Charlie Villanueva is checked in for Splitter. Screen by Villanueva. Lawson the pass to Sanders. The shot by Butler. Nobody around.
Oh, man.
The long-range jumper. Butler's got 10.
And you can see he just caught a glimpse of the open man on the perimeter and immediately got him the basketball.
Watson kicks to Bogut. feeds to Watson. Three-pointer.
The bold move of going right back at him to return the three, but he just couldn't get it to go.
And Lawson, here we go.
Come on. Yes.
In from the high post.
Well, I think he had all the space he needed. He just couldn't find the bottom of the net.
Screen by Young. Watson kicks to Bogut. With 2 seconds left. And the layup is good.
There.
Bogut's got 4 points now in the quarter. And the first half
comes.
We've got a close game going on here. The Rockets on top, leading by a point. From the Pepsi Center in downtown Denver, we're back in a moment.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, this has been a good game here after one half. Everybody, welcome back to the halftime show. Ernie Johnson, Shaq, Kenny Smith. Gordon Hayward has been all over the floor tonight. He had 12 points and one rebound. Kenny, what'd you think about the Rockets?
Well, they were lighting it up from three, and that was the difference in the first half. They did a good job of running off screen, spotting up, and getting rid of the ball quickly. And their shot selection, solid.
And big fella, let's get your thoughts on the Nuggets.
Well, it was a huge first half for their bench, a.k.a. the others, played pretty good. When you get a boost like this, it always gives the team a lift. And given how well the others are contributing, we'll probably continue to see more minutes for them in the second half. Starters or not, when players are producing, you gotta ride them, cowboy.
And now, folks, it's just about time for the third quarter to begin. We will see you
after
the final buzzer.
Frickin' more of everything than them, and I'm still losing. Frickin' crap. Alright, let's go.
The third quarter now beginning. Both sides looking to pull away in the last half of the game. Gordon Hayward with another strong contribution.
My
ad. This one.
Way over here.
Boy, did he put on a show from beyond in that first half. Let's see if the halftime break has any cooling effect on
him. Oh, my goodness.
I'll tell you what. We'll soon find out because I guarantee they're going to keep feeding it to him behind the arc until he does cool off.
Getting underway in the second half.
Come on, man. Miss it. Come on, Jimmy. Miss.
Washing out there with Jimmy Butler.
Of course.
Then there's Tyler Hansbrough. And it's Hayward in at the three, the small forward.
Really impressed with the way Jimmy Butler last season made big strides in his game, going from a supporting role player to someone you can build your team.
There we go.
Lee hits the bucket.
Yeah, starting the second half nicely there. Love those easy lay-ins to get things going.
There's a screen by Hansbrough.
Come on.
Butler kicks to Hayward. Beyond the arc, the shot.
Freaking Gordon Hayward stole making threes.
Had the career highs across the board last season. Won the Most Improved Player of the Year award. Really picking up his production in his fourth season.
You know, we had seen the flashes of potential in Butler before. Last season.
Oh, come on, Noah. Why? Why?
To the next level.
Why you have to be open down there?
Wide open.
Come on! No!
Splitter.
Oh, are you serious?
A few more points tacked on
to
in the cruelest way possible.
You're right. Yeah, those putback jams sting, don't they? My goodness.
Yeah, they really hurt you. I mean, the defense forces a miss and then can't rebound it and finish off the defense. They're hanging their heads in their chest now.
Clock at four.
No!
By Lawson.
Come on!
And here comes Lawson, leading the fast break. That's good.
Oh, seriously? Come on!
Here to start the half.
You know, Clark, the one thing you can say about Ty Lawson is his awareness around the floor. He's just ubiquitous, and his court vision is incredible.
Excellent peripheral vision. He averaged almost 2 points per game last season. That's the best year of his career thus far.
Exum, he's checked in for Houston. Pick by Lee. Paul kicks it to Noah.
Not who I wanted to go to, of course.
It's Ariza on the wing. Defended by Hayward. Hayward against Ariza. Can they get it?
And again, come on!
Boston, playmaking isn't a concern. He's got that. His shooting accuracy, though, seems to drop every year. In fact, the last 2 years have been the worst of his career.
Here's Lee. Now that is his seventh field goal in 10 tries. He's shooting a very good 70%.
Well, they certainly didn't have much of a problem getting the ball into the post that time.
Yeah, and that's important because this game may ultimately come down to which team controls the paint in crunch time.
Here's Exum. Here's Splitter. And that comes off the assist by Exum.
Freaking heck!
Exum's got three assists now in this one.
Yeah, you know, going back to Lawson's declining shooting percentage, really no apparent reason for it. Last year, he launched the fewest threes in his past four seasons, but he still couldn't find the rhythm, and it really hurt his team down the stretch.
Left side Ariza, this one for three.
No, man! Come on!
Here's Lee. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two.
Well, how about David Lee in this one? He's got 14 points and one assist.
And we've all watched him just be an unstoppable force here tonight.
Well, nothing they've done on the defensive end has been able to slow him down. I mean, he's doing exactly what he wants to when he wants to do it.
Here's what Denver's going with right now. Andrew Bogut, he's checked in for Noah. And it's Nick Calathes in for Trevor Ariza. Hansbrough dishes to Exum. Down low. And two free
throws. Oh, you freaking kidding me.
That's on Andrew Bogut.
And you know what? You allow a guy to get right to the rim like that. That's your only option.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, free throws are always better than a layup. So I'd agree with you there, Greg.
A different look for Denver. Thaddeus Young. He's checked in for Lee. Bellinelli comes in for Kyle Korver. And it's Watson in for Chris Paul.
And the Rockets were a tough team last year, but at times it really felt like a one-man show. Harden carried them so much for so long. You just
Hayward passes to Exum. Here's Sanders, and that comes off.
Dang it, man!
Exum's got his fourth assist.
Come on, dude.
Pass to Bellinelli. Bogut against Sanders. Here's Young. And the layup's good off the glass.
Thaddeus Young.
And if carrying the team during the regular season or Harden down, Greg, as you're talking about, it didn't show that much in the playoffs. Harden was phenomenal most, if not Clark, all of the postseason.
I would agree with you, but there also were some other guys for Houston that did step up in the postseason. Howard looked as good as he did before all of his injuries as a case in point.
Yeah, no doubt about that one with the over-the-back call.
Yeah, it looked like he wanted to take him for a ride right there. Easy call.
Charlie Villanueva's checked in for Houston. Oubre comes in for Gordon Hayward. Bogut kicks to Young. Sanders
that's what we call good defense in the paint.
Well,
it's weight and goal.
It absolutely is. Without his presence, that's an easy basket.
The Nuggets missed the postseason again last year. Never really had a good look at it. Just fell in back of the pack.
And it's the second straight year of not playing playoff basketball in Denver. This coming on the heels of 10 straight bursts between 04 and 13.
And the Rockets making a change here. Lawson's checked in. Here's Bellinelli. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
And, you know, for Denver, historically, they've enjoyed a lot of success for a long time. I mean, missing the playoffs consecutively might have been the wake-up call they needed to try something different going forward.
And listen, it's sometimes really hard for teams like the Nuggets to know when to rebuild. So while they weren't quite sure what they had coming in the last season, by the end of it, they had a clear idea of what direction
come
they needed to
head into. Oh, my God, dude.
There's 42 seconds left in the third quarter. Now, here's Watson. He's covered closely. He kicks it to Young. Cans the shot with nobody near him. Young's got 4 points now in the quarter. Lawson with it. High arcing shot. Rebound Bogut. Bogut's got three rebounds now in this one. And Bellinelli kicks to Calathes.
And they can guarantee this is the last possession of the quarter if they hold it.
And I'm guessing that's exactly what they're probably going to do here.
Here's Villanueva. And it's off from three-point range. Young. No good.
Your Nuggets dancers!
And the final period of play just about to start. Kyle Korver is out there with Paul. Then it's Young. Then there's Noah. And it's Lee in at the four slot. That's the group in the game for the Nuggets. Rebound, Gordon Hayward.
Well, one of his issues is he's a player that just does not excel at fighting through contact on his way to the rim.
Splitter kicks to Lawson. Nailed from
three-point line. Oh, my God. Come on.
With the first basket of the period here for Houston. Paul against Lawson. Paul dishes to Lee. And here is Noah. Back to Paul. Noah with a screen on Lawson. Here's Paul. And he connects on the jumper. The screen did the trick.
And he came off that screen, and the D just didn't get over the top of it.
Yep, weren't there in time enough to challenge, Greg. And when that's the case, you can mark those up for him.
Come on, get that.
Lawson.
Even though he isn't having the best of games from the floor, it hasn't seemed to hurt him.
Young pass to Lee, takes the 12-footer and hits.
Feeling it. No doubt about it. He's definitely feeling it right now, shooting a terrific percentage from the field.
Well, looking back on last season, you didn't know where the Rockets would end up in terms of seeding in the playoffs. Ended up with the 2 seed because they won the Southwest Division. And as it turned out, everything worked out very well for him.
It really did, and had a divisional matchup in that first round against the Mavs. But the Rockets took care of business in that series and would advance.
A moment to check in with Doris Burke. Doris?
Well, guys, Kevin McHale had some advice for the team in that last break.
Oh!
Players, let's put our foot on them and keep them down.
We've freaking AI always lets me down, man.
I want to see you guys slow the pace. Use the clock and stay away from any silly fouls.
And you know, for the Rockets, they had a major gut check in the second round. Went down 3-1 against the Clippers.
What? I didn't want to pass to him.
Including game 6, when I dozed off when they were trailing.
Oh, come on, Noah. Oh, my God. He's terrible. Maybe I should just put Bogut in. Freaking Noah sucks.
Lawson outside. Splitter sets a screen. Lawson kicks the butt. 5 on the clock. Noah with the block. Lee dishes to Korver. Here's Paul. And
Oh, my God.
Korver passes to Ariza. The tray.
Good. A wide open 3. They need much better communication defensively.
For those just joining us, fourth quarter here. We're just over 2.5 minutes into it.
And with the Rockets' last postseason, their trip to the conference finals was as far as they would go. Went out to the Warriors in 5 games. Most of them, though, close ones. I think most fans are pleased with how far the team went last year in spite of all the injuries.
The drive by Paul. Ariza outside. It's stolen by Hansbrough.
Oh, come on!
Pushing it up. No one back to stop him. Hammers it on the polish off.
Oh, my goodness!
I love the power.
Oh, this is such frustrating me.
Strong contribution so far in this one.
He's dialed in from long range. They got to stay in his hip pocket and deny him the catch.
The Nuggets trail by 9. Paul outside, top of the key. Denver gets it.
Come on.
Noah kicks to Paul. Good, and a nice assist from Noah. And that's 11 points for Chris Paul.
They
They've gotten some good second chances here in the second half, and that kind of extra effort will go a long way into cutting into this deficit.
Noah with the block.
Butler against Korver. Top of the key, Noah. Butler with the steal.
My guy can't dribble! What crap!
No good. Now Denver takes it the other way. Here's Noah.
Oh,
Good with the triple.
My God!
How you want to close the gap. They've got to have better shot selection.
Andrew Bogut. He's checked in for Denver. Lawson kicks to Hayward. Dishes to Hansbrough. And that one's good. The Nuggets trail by 9. Paul outside. Pulls up. And that one goes long.
You're not going to see that very often. Plenty of space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffed.
Oh!
Man, he just punishes the D for falling asleep at the wheel.
A little disorganized that time, and the result, 2 points in the loudest way possible.
Guys, there has to be better rim protection than that, though. Not very good.
Oh, that was a great angle we just saw, courtesy of Kia. Lawson dishes to Hayward. Splitter sets a screen. Butler with the ball. Now defended by Korver. Hansbrough, that's good. Hansbrough's got 4 points in the quarter.
And it looks like just playing the last bit of this one out in what should be a nice win here for the Rockets.
They found a great rhythm from long range.
They sure did, Kevin. Every time they left the man open deep, he'd get a good look at the basket. And they didn't hesitate, and the aggressiveness paid off.
And now, for the year, this is going to take them to 7 wins.
And regaining their momentum against a team that had already beaten them once this year, this win makes it a 1-1 tie in their best of 3 season series against the Nuggets.
And we've come to expect nothing less from one of the league's elite players, but another tour de force for Butler. There wasn't much they could do to slow him down as he was converting every good chance he got. Terrific run to seal.
Dumb AI. Stupid AI. Freaking dumb retarded AI.
And that one falls for Splitter.
When you're hot, you're hot. And that's certainly been the case for Splitter. He's got 14 points, and he's created a lot of chances for his teammates also.
And Clark, some of those assists that he's got today have been just electric.
Goes in, goes out, of course. That's how this game goes. Freaking shit.
Watson the pass to Hayward. That is in there.
Bullcrap. Stupid nonsense. Freaking stupid.
They've just done a great job of keeping this crowd out of the game. And we're getting closer to victory.
Screw this game. Screw it.
Anymore. I mean, their guys got it handed to them.
Now Bellinella. Off target with his 3. Now here's Exum.
The dumb retarded game. Dumb. Freaking stupid. Screw this. You know what?
And that's a foul.
Screw you.
Nick Kalathis. That's his first foul of the game, and the bonus will go to the free throw line. That's good from Exum.
Dumb nonsense. Screw this game. Screw it.
Exum hits them both.
Freaking dumb, retarded game. NBA 2K16 is so retarded.
So easy.
Stupid game. Dumb. Freaking. This game sucks.
And that's what you want to do.
This is how it went last year. Show.
Thank you, Kevin. And now we get a chance to present our Jordan player of the game, Gordon Hayward. He's not always known to make the big headlines or get a lot of media attention, but he does make the big plays, and he made them throughout this one.
You gotta love the contribution from deep. He hit 4 threes. I think that his threat on the perimeter also contributed in terms of their ball movement, using the options and going inside.
You got to love Gordon Hayward. He's going to get you rebounds, he's going to get you assists, and you know he's going to get you points. And there's a motor on this fella that will not quit. Hayward never stops working. He's one of the most exciting stars in the league.
And folks, that's it for us. Thank you for tuning in. Always a pleasure. For Kenny...
I am gonna put Bogut in for Noah. Noah is a piece of crap.